As you know that Canada has one of the best education system and we provide you all the information about Canada. So here we go. We gather all the information about Canada schooling. We will be sharing all the information that you need. If you will be planning to admit your kid in a school or you want to know everything about education system in Canada. So let's start the video. Before we move on, if you are coming for the first time, we definitely recommend you to subscribe the channel so that you don't miss such kind of informational videos about Canada.
So we have basically divided this video into three parts. In the first part, we'll be talking about different type of schools that we have in Canada. Secondly, we'll talk about the grading system. And third and most important one is how can your child be admitted in a school? So let's start with the first category, which is type of schools in Canada. So we normally have two major categories. First one is public schools and second one is private schools. Public schools are nothing but publicly funded schools. So it's mainly the taxpayers' money that is used to run these schools. These are run by government and mainly the provinces have a hold on these schools. So you will see that the education system of one province may differ from some other province. So they have province-specific rules. 95% of kids in Canada go to public schools.
I think that is similar to government schools in South Asian countries, I would say. And level of education that they get in public school is very similar to private school. She will share all the points about it. You will realize that how good the quality is for public schools.
If we talk about cost, so parents don't have to pay any money for getting their child admitted to a public school, which is really, really great. Yeah. So mainly you don't have to pay the tuition fee, any fee related to transportation, any fee related to textbooks, it is all included. What you really need to pay for is the stationery cost. So any stationery that your child will use, you'll have to pay that cost. And yes, like lunchbox cost as well. Like in case you are sending your kid with lunchbox from home, there's no cost. But there are some cases where you can opt for some school programs where you can get the lunch from the school. So they'll charge you a minimal fees for that. So it again varies from school to school.
And I don't think the stationery cost will be much. It will be very less.
Most of the schools have extracurricular activities. So that means if your kid wants to participate in some sports or some other activities, you will have to pay the cost for that. So that is not free in public schools. I think that makes sense also because not every kid is interested in the same kind of sports or activities, so you can choose the right sports or activities based on your kid's interest. And the best thing, especially for kids, there's no uniform in public schools, so you can wear whatever you feel comfortable in, so that's really good for
your
kids.
Your children will be very happy to know that. I mean, it was surprising for me that there is no uniform, but it is good.
But that means for parents, they'll have to bear some additional cost to buy some good clothes for the school.
Yeah.
So you'll have to pay some money for that.
They cannot go in the same uniform. Like you can have two uniforms in India, Pakistan, let's say. But here they will wear different dress every day.
Also, public schools cannot deny admission for your kids to their school unless the class is already full with the number of students in the class. Now let's talk about private schools. So there are approximately 5% of Canadian kids who go to private schools. So there are some parents who think that their kid needs some special attention. Maybe their kid is good in a specific sport or maybe some activities, so they want the kid to go in a specific school that has focus on those activities. And moreover, there are some parents who are concerned about overcrowding in public school classes. Maybe they want the kid to sit in a class that has limited number of kids. It doesn't mean that public schools have like a really overcrowded class, but still, like some parents have that thing in mind. Normally, if you have money and if you think that you can afford that education, on an average, the school fee for an elementary school kid in a private school is around $2,000. Plus, if the school is far from the house, you'll have to bear the cost for transportation. So it will be around $2,500 per month if you can afford it. And if you really want your kid to go there, you can opt for it. Another reason why parents send their kids to private schools may be that the area where they are living right now doesn't have really good schools, which is like really rare. But if they think that it is not a good school and they want to send their kid to a really good school and the cost of sending the kid to a good school is less than their moving cost, so they opt for a private school. So in private schools, mainly the parents will have to bear the cost for the tuition fee, for the transportation fee, for any extracurricular activities that the kid is doing. Plus, there's a uniform in a private school, so you'll have to pay money towards the uniform. So that's like a lot of cost.
So in Crux, very, very rich people here in Canada send their children to private school because there is not much difference in public and private, but still, for that slight difference, you have to pay a lot. If you have money, you can send your kids to private school. We will not do that because, one, we don't have money. Plus, there is no big difference between the studies of a public school and a private school. So as you can see, the background has changed because it started raining. So we had to come back home. We can continue the video now.
So we were talking about private schools. So in private schools, unlike public, they have a specific set of requirements when it comes to admissions. So for example, they may check your salaries or they may tell your kid to appear for an entrance exam. And moreover, they can have some aptitude tests for parents as well. So it's more on the discretion of the school. So you have to be aware of these things. And it is not at all easy to get into a private school. So you may have to plan ahead, maybe 1 year in advance, if you plan to send your kid to a private school. So these were the two main type of schools that we have in Canada. In some provinces, you may have Catholic or religious schools. And in some provinces, you also have an option to do homeschooling for kids. So in Ontario, like I know there are some areas where you can opt for homeschooling, but personally, I just feel like if kids are sent to school, if they can learn with other kids, it will help them with overall development, which is the key focus in most of the Canadian schools.
And while we're talking about level of education, yes, in Canadian schools, they emphasize a lot on practical knowledge, live experience knowledge. They send the kids to experience the nature and learn by themselves. There are no books, specific books for any classes. So that is very different as compared to from where we are coming from India. We know that studies are very difficult. It is very competitive. So there are some parents who are sending their kids from Canada to India, let's say in the summer break, to be very competitive in Canadian schools, because people who are coming from India, they think that the studies are not as difficult as it used to be in India. So they put a lot of effort to make it very close to Indian study, which we used to do. So you can also think about it. But in terms of math, because math is one of the important subjects, so we came across UMath. If you are concerned about mathematical intelligence of your kid, you should give it a try. As you know that every parent is working from home and kids are studying online, so this is an amazing opportunity for the parents to provide other option to their kids to learn new skills. QMath is a math learning platform which has tutor to teach students from KG to 10th standard. More than 94% of parents are satisfied with this platform because it is enhancing kids' analytical ability and reasoning capabilities. The best part of this platform is that sessions are very interactive and the teachers make it very easy for kids to understand the subjects. Your child will not only learn math, but can learn new skills as well. QMath also provides classes to children to learn how to code. They can learn how to create new application and website as well at very early age. They will get chance to learn math from IITians and CEO of biggest organization. This is the best way to learn math sitting home during the lockdown period. Enroll your child and see the change in them working out math in better. You can even book a free slot as well from the link given in the description below. So we will definitely recommend that you should try this.
Now let's talk about the grading structure in Canada. So each province has its own grading structure. So it again varies from province to province. We are in Ontario, so we'll be sharing what happens or what grading structures do we have in Ontario. So mainly Ontario has three grading structures. First is elementary school. So mainly kids who are in junior kindergarten to grade 6 go to this school. Next is middle school, which means grade 7 and 8. Some provinces have grades 7, 8 and 9 covered, so it again varies as we said. Next is high school. So from grade 9 till grade 12 is mainly the high school.
And it is very different from where we are coming from. So in India, the grading system were very different. Here, we need to get used to this grading system.
So if we talk about school sessions, sessions normally start here in early September and run through June. So you will also have a lot of breaks in between. There are March breaks that are for 2 weeks. Then you have breaks during Christmas time, that is again 2 weeks. And you also have 2 months breaks in July and August. That's like a lot of vacations.
Yeah.
And you will get other stat holidays as well.
And mostly stat holidays, like public holidays in Canada, fall on Fridays or Mondays. So that's very great. You can plan long weekends, vacations with your kids when they have leaves.
And normally the schools are from Monday to Friday from 8:45 till 3:15 p.m. So you can plan your kids' activities accordingly. So we get a lot of questions about working parents. Obviously, like when you are working, your offices normally start early in morning. So schools normally have some programs where you can send your kid to school early and you have to pay for those extra hours. I think it's $25 to $30 per day. So you can adjust your schedule accordingly.
Which means you can send your kid early in the morning before the school starts. And once you log out from office, you reach school, you can pick your kid. So they will take care of the kid before the school starts and after the school gets closed for a few hours.
And moreover, you can enroll your kids for a lot of extracurricular activities that normally happen after the school hours. So you can plan accordingly and have a schedule set. Another good thing of Canadian schools is that they focus a lot on nutrition for the kids, which means your kids' lunch should have proper amount of carbohydrates, proteins, fruits, juices, etc. So they really focus on these things. If for some reason you are not able to prepare proper lunch boxes for your kids, normally schools have a program where you can pay some fee to the school and they can give lunch to the kids and that will be proper nutrition food, which is a great thing.
Especially for working parents, I would say.
Now let's talk about how exactly can you get your kid admitted to a school. So the first and foremost step is to find your school board. What does that mean? Suppose you are living in Brampton, so you will go online and look for Peel Region Board. Then there will be an option to find your local schools. So you will have to enter the postal code of the area where you are living right now. And based on your postal code, they will provide you with a list of all the schools and you can choose the school that is best for your kid.
And now comes the part where you can decide where to buy a house or rent a house, because depending on the postal code and the school which are falling under 3 kilometer radius, you can go online and check the rating for those schools. So let's say if you have shortlisted top 5 schools in Peel region, so according to that, as per your preference, you can decide where to rent a house or where to buy a house. So this is very important. And if you're planning ahead for your kids, you need to decide where you're buying a house depending on the good schools that you have shortlisted.
So we will provide a link in description. That's Fraser Institute that normally does these rankings. So you can go and check that link and maybe try some random areas and based on that you can decide. Now once you have shortlisted the school and you're going to the school for getting your kid admitted, there are few documents that most of the schools require. First and foremost is the birth certificate of your kid. Second is his or her ID proofs. Third is residency proofs. So in case you are renting an apartment or a house, you should have the proper documents with you when you are going for the admissions. Next is vaccination proofs. So that is like really important here. Each kid will have to go through some vaccinations throughout the years. So you need to have those proofs with you. Suppose you are coming from a different country, so you can bring all the proofs of vaccinations that you got for your kid in that country.
Here I would say one document, which is date of birth certificate, is very important. So when you're coming to Canada on PR, you need to make sure that you're bringing your kid's date of birth certificate as well.
Last but not the least, you should provide a proper emergency contact where the school can reach out to in case of an emergency. Also, there are a lot of settlement organizations who help the newcomers with all this information. So we will put a link in description which you can check, and I'm sure that will surely help you with a lot of your questions.
So we hope all of this information will be very helpful for you. If you are planning to come to Canada or you are already in the process, then this will be very helpful. So we try to cover everything, but still if you have any question, you can comment down below or you can join our Facebook group, which has more than 130,000 members right now. So they will be able to answer your questions. If you love watching vlogs, we have a vlogging channel as well. That's in Hindi, but we put English subtitles for the English speaking audience. You can check that out. If you need to book an appointment with the licensed immigration consultant, then there's a link in the description. You can check that as well. Do not forget to like this video. If you have reached till here, I hope you liked it. And do not forget to press the subscribe button so that you get notified next time when we put such awesome video.
And also let us know if you want to know anything specific. We'll try and cover that in our next videos. So till next time,
stay safe
and stick around.